Today, bird flight is spectacularly complex. They soar with ease. But the transition from a ground-based life to one in the skies would not have been an easy one. It's something that scientists are still trying to understand. How did birds first take flight? There are several ideas of how this happened. The first, known as the tree down hypothesis, suggests that tree-dwelling birds flap their wings to cushion their landing. The second, known as the ground up hypothesis, emphasizes the use of wing flapping associated with running to escape danger or catch up with prey. But recently, another theory has been suggested, one that can be seen in birds today.
So these are our performers today. So this is Olympia in gray here. This is Annie in brown. And this is Twinkle Jemima, or Twinkie for short.
To analyze the movement of the wings in detail, evolutionary biologist Ashley Hears needs to see them in slow motion.
Here I've got my high-speed video camera, and I can visualize what the camera is seeing on the laptop. And so you can see that she's really using her wings to break as she gets ready to land there. I actually spend a lot of my time working with developing birds or baby birds because it can also tell us a lot about the evolution of flight. And in many ways, they look similar to some of the fossils that we see that are documenting this origin of flight. And so in these developing birds, we have this really interesting system where we can see in real time how a living animal goes from a flightless animal to a flight-capable animal and everything that happens in between, both anatomically and behaviorally.
One of the behaviors seen is wing-assisted running on an inclined plane.
So on the left here, we have a 4-day-old chirker partridge. It is flapping its wings to really drive itself into the substrate here and increase traction with its feet so that it can ascend this steep incline.
This is not the only behavior that hints that dinosaurs were able to develop flapping flight.
They may use their wings to leap into the air and fly, either for a very short distance or for thousands of miles. They also use their wings to come down out of trees or off of elevated surfaces, even to swim either across the water or below the water. And so living birds show us that, you know, they use lots of different habitats and they use their wings for lots of different functions.
Bird flight developed as an adaptation to the environment, as well as to allow gliding down from trees or to evade predators on land.